Okay guys, today we are going to finish our HTML part and we'll begin with the CSS, but we'll try to finish the HTML part soon so that we can have an intro on CSS. So any doubt from the previous sessions, you can ask, or I'm moving towards the next topic. No doubts. Guys, can I move forward to the next topic if you don't have any doubts to anyone? Dilip, I show you, I have one example for you guys. If we don't close explicitly, what are the code causes or what are the errors you can get? I'll show you that. Firstly, we'll cover our HTML part. While finishing it, we'll do that. Okay guys, today's first topic is HTML canvas. So by the name only you can understand what is canvas. Canvas is nothing. We are having a, if you can imagine a 2D screen or 2D a chart paper, white chart paper. So similar kind of thing is that. But in HTML, from now on, whatever we going to have our topics in our classes, we need to use some other language. Other web parts also like JavaScript, or we need to use the CSS. So quickly we will finish our, in a half an hour we'll finish our HTML part, because this will be repeating. I'm going to repeat that when we are at the JavaScript, so that you can have better understanding for these topics. Okay guys, yeah, so right now I'm seeing my screen and it's showing the HTML canvas page. So I'm already saying you that the HTML page having like a white screen. So you are having a white screen and you want to draw some graphics on that page. So we are going to do with the canvas, or we are going to do with the SVG. So firstly we'll cover the canvas part, then we will move towards the SVG part. So canvas, canvas is about, a canvas is an element which we are going to use to draw the graphics on our HTML web page, right? So graphics is, the graphic to the left is created with canvas. So why it's written? So by default, so already, when we going to create it, automatically created at the left side. So we are having the, shows the four element that the, okay, this is the another thing. I'll show you after that. So what is HTML canvas actually about? So and canvas is to draw the graphic on the fly via JavaScript. What does that mean, on the fly via JavaScript? So on the fly means whenever you change in your JavaScript part, so we have to use this in a with JavaScript. So when we are going to change in our JavaScript part, now on the fly the HTML page will change. So you don't need to run the explicitly. So canvas element is only a container for graphics, and you must use JavaScript to actually draw the graphics. So it's clearly written that to draw the graphics, we have to use the JavaScript. So right now, if I explain you how to write a JavaScript, that will be difficult for you. Some students have understanding about the JavaScript, but some might not have. So we'll cover this again, but right now I'll give you the introduction about this, okay? So we can actually draw circles, boxes, some text we are want to have on a particular position, or we want to add some images, we can do with the canvas, but we have several methods for that. So we have to implement those methods, we have to use those methods to implement HTML canvas. But guys, from this canvas, this is not supported by all the browsers. So clearly, I am here mentioning in a table format which browser version is supporting the canvas part. From that version, the browser in supporting the HTML canvas. But if you are using before, like Internet Explorer Edge part, before using the 8th version, it will not work. Okay, so here is first example for canvas. So if we want to draw a rectangle area on our HTML page, or if we want to draw another thing, so in our rectangle, as you know, we are having pixels in our full frame HTML. Guys, do you understand the frame part? If I say frame, what does that mean according to you? Quickly, can you reply? Okay. I got one reply. Boundaries, okay, border. Guys, framework, frame is nothing. It's like you are having a screen on your laptop. So there is some pixels over there you have set, like 1080 into 764, might you understand that part? So that is the frame for you. In that frame only you have to design your HTML. So right now, if I'm having a laptop screen 15 inches, so it might be some having a pixel range like 1080 to 764, or might be 1080 to 1080. I don't know. So whatever will be the base thing, then that will be your frame. In that frame only, you have to draw your graphics. Okay. So first of all, to have be rectangle area on HTML page. So attributes. So there is a attributes like we have to identify. Okay. Guys, give me a second. Yeah, guys, now it's okay. I have changed my network. Am I audible? Yeah, really sorry, guys. This is due to the bad weather. Outside, there is very not good weather. So, might we have to reconnect to our new network again. So continuing the part, so I'm saying canvas having the element canvas, and these are the attributes, the ID. ID must always specify the ID, because with this ID only, you are going to draw a graphics in your next examples. I'm going to explain that how you are going to use that ID. Okay. So actually it will be wrapped in a script. So after that, the width and the height attribute, because you have to define the size of the canvas, in which size you want to draw graphics. And to add a border, you need to add a style attribute. Right now, there is one example here. So I'm going to show that example to you. Right, guys, here you can see we have mentioned the canvas, the ID my canvas, width 200, height 100, and I have mentioned some style to the border, right? And if my canvas is not supported by my browser, then this text will be displayed. So guys, now if we want to draw graphics now, so here are the some examples, but this is actually what about, this is a JavaScript code. So we need to declare some variable, we need to have variables, and we need to use some methods to draw the graphics. So if you want, I can explain to you right now, and if you want, we can do it later. It's up to you. So okay, now we'll do one thing. We just get a one or two examples. Later on I'll explain you in a brief, in a detail also. Right now I'll explain you in a brief. Okay, so if we run our first example for the canvas, so right now we have given the 200 width and 100 height. So in that only he has drawn the line, because we are seeing the code for the writing a drawer line. So how it's actually doing, it's actually giving, we are having the ID. So we have from that ID, we are getting that value in a variable C, and we have to give this context to another variable. C and CTX is nothing. These are the variables who can have the values whichever you provide. So what is actually get element by ID, what is actually get context, you are able to understand when we are having the JavaScript part. Okay guys, so right now you can see I have used some methods, move to, line to, stroke. So there is implementation of these method already in the canvas. We have to just implement that. So we are having, I'm not going to move anywhere. So I've given the 0, 0. So you can see is showing my canvas at the top left, right. Right. So if we give here some values, like if I want to move 10 pixels, so I just want to move from 10 from the left side, and I'm just saving that, and we will refresh our page here. So line is moved from the 10. Are you guys able to see that? So line is moved from the 10 pixels. So if I want to have that at the 50th pixel, so it will start from the top from that, and from the left it will start from the 10. So right, according to that you can mention your XY coordinates from where you want to start and from where you want to end that. So easily you can make a line here. But if I change here only line to 100 to 100, what does that mean? So right now we'll see. Okay, it's better if I can do 0, 0 here. So you are easily able to understand what does that doing. Okay guys, I have given, please do 100 here from starting from 100 only, but ending at 100 only. We have given 200 width. So at the 100 width, it's ending the line. Are you able to catch up this part? I know this is not a JavaScript, but just simply if I go for XY coordinates, it will be easy to understand. If you can imagine with the XY coordinates, we have given the 100 and 100 only. If we given 50 here, so what is he going to do? He's going to start from the 100 part and ending at 50 only. Okay guys, when will you practice, you are able to know how XY coordinates will work. But it's actually only XY coordinates, we are giving some values, and according to that he is going to draw the line. Okay guys, stroke will do nothing. Stroke will just draw a line for you. And this is actually a JavaScript part, whole part. Okay guys, can we move further? Any doubts? I know this is not, we have just not covered the JavaScript. Might be you are able not able to understand this part right now, but I'm sure when we are at the JavaScript, you now will able to understand what these things actually doing. Yeah, yeah, surely we are going to have this in a JavaScript, because document and get element by ID, this will be your key part in JavaScript. You have to do these things to run your JavaScript part. Okay, if we go for the another examples to draw a circle, these are the arcs we have to define actually. So you will guys able to understand to draw a circle gradient. So I have made already examples for you. If I just run this, this is a circular gradient, but behind this, if we see the view page source code, whole thing is in the JavaScript part only. We are just defining our canvas in our canvas element, but to just draw a circular gradient there, we have to do that this JavaScript part. It's actually doing nothing. It's just creating the gradient from these three lines, and from filling that part, doing from that only. But to understand this, you have to practice these things. And I have talked to the Gurukul team in a one, tomorrow, might be tomorrow, you will get the material also day-wise. The PDF and the examples also. Okay, guys. And please let me know if you don't receive the material, I'll ask them to share with you. Because without practice, it will be very difficult for you guys to how you will practice. I really want you to have these documents so that it will be crisp documents. It will be very beneficial for you guys. And if you want, you can also have an online study. And if you have any doubt, just come up with your doubts. We'll surely do that. Moving towards the SVG. So what is SVG? It's also a, just to draw graphics, but it's used to define a graphics for the web. And actually it's a W3 recommendation. What is W3 recommendation, W3C recommendations? Any idea? Okay. It's like a standards. There are some standards we have to follow. So some recommendations are there from different parties. So this is actually recommended by our W3C. So it stands for actually scalable vector graphics. It's from name only you are able to understand. We have, it's also using for graphics only. It's also a container for graphics as a canvas. It's also doing the same thing. We are also having a different methods to draw same text, circles, graphics, images. Then what's the difference? Let's see. We'll do that. And same thing, there's also some browser support written here only. So which browser will support SVG part? Okay, guys. So here also the same thing, guys. Now I think you can easily cope up that what is SVG? SVG is the element. Okay, and it should have, guys, please tell me, it should have, if element is there, what will it's going to have? It's clearly, yeah, attributes. It's clearly we are having width and height here. So same thing we are doing in the canvas, we are giving the ID there, but we if we don't want to give ID, it's okay. But there is some difference. There is difference we are doing with the JavaScript part. Here you can mention here, the circle is the element for the under the SVG. And after that you have to give these things. You can Google these things, you can easily get it. I'm just saying that stroke with green, but fill with yellow. Okay, so So if we run this SVG first example, it will show like that. Isn't it great? This looks like if you are able to do SVG in your web pages, you can more make images like circle and draw. You can write in, if you want to fill with some text, you can fill it. But it's up to you. It's up to your creativity. Okay, guys. So here's some difference. How SVG is working, how Canvas is working. I want you to guys to read this. I'll share the document today finally with the Gurukul team. They are going to send you. But if you want to compare these things, just in a table format, here's the example. But actually, I really want you to practice this. Only then you are able to understand what is actually the difference is there. If I explain you here the resolution dependent, resolution independent, I don't think so it will make any sense. You can, if you want to tell anybody, you can tell from these things only. But if you really want to understand, you have to implement these things. Okay? So please try to read this carefully and just let me know if you are not able to understand. We'll surely do that. Just one example, just one difference, which will be easily for understandable for you. Canvas is actually used in a games part, but for the gaming application, SVG is not suitable. But if you mentioned here the UI part, because it rendered slow, but it cannot Canvas rendered very fastly. So here are some properties difference. So you can have these things, okay? I know we are moving towards some difficult part. Please let me know if you want me to devote some more time to these things. I'll devote, but I really want to understand these things. But you can really use the thing in your HTML pages, but it's good to have things. Okay? Like this only you can save the image in the PNG and format. You can't save. It's best suited for the application like areas. You want to show some area, you can have this SVG part. If we run this second example, this will look nice. I have rounded the corners and filled with some color. If you see those, you can see there is only one line who is doing everything. In Canvas, you have seen, we are having 6-7 lines in the JavaScript, only then he is doing, the part is doing. But here, I have mentioned only width, height, then there is a rectangle part, X coordinate, Y coordinate, RX, RY, you are going to do research, you will be able to understand what is doing. 150 height and width in that SVG. SVG is having full width of height of 400 and 180, but a rectangle is having a width of height and width 150 only, respectively. Style I'm saying fill with red, stroke with black, opacity I'm giving. So from that only you are able to understand how it's actually working. It will show like this. If we change the color, if you want me to change, right now if you want me to change the color, I can change the color, I can change the XY coordinates. But if you can do these things, I think so that will be better. What say, if you want, I can change right now and show you what's actually happening. You want me to do or you want to do practice at your end? Am I audible, guys? Because I'm not getting the response from your end. Yeah, you have to learn. On very first day, I have tell you, you have to practice, you have to come up with your creativity. If you have doubt, just come to me, but you have to learn. I can tell you how you can implement. Right now, I'm showing you that one example. If I show you this example, I'm showing you, you have to do the circle part, but until or unless you are implementing this, no, you are not implementing this thing, you are not able to understand how it's worked. You have to change the values. You have to see what's actually making the circle. Yeah, it's good. Because right earlier we are having this thing, I'm going to change the color, I'm going to change these things. But now it's up to you how you want to look your page like. So you will change the height, width, color, opacity. What's opacity actually doing? You have to do that. It will be very beneficial for you. I already knowing these things. Right now I have do this thing. What is actually you are seeing this thing? This is nothing. This is some linear gradient part, their depth. So I'm doing the ellipse part here. Sure, guys. Any doubt till now? I know it's not clear, more clear to you because you have not practiced yet. Might be first time you are listening to this. Okay, Sahil, I have a. This is the properties only. If you see the depth partner, the definition. We are going to define the graphics here. Depth stand for define. Guys, that's why I'm saying if you read the documents now, you will easily understand what actually you're going to do. Here I'm writing the second liner, which is used to define the graphics of the web. Define. How will you define? You have to use the depth. You are going to define. Okay? So please read your documents and try to draw this. If you stuck anywhere, just let me know. We'll surely resolve your issues. Might be I'll learn from you because I'm not that expert. Sahil, you have asked me yesterday one question. Can be position, right? And he's not he's in the class. Yeah, he's in the class. Okay, when he'll reply, I'll clear his doubt. So, moving towards. Okay, guys, moving towards our next topic. So, what will be our next topic? Our next topic will be drag and drop. So guys, HTML is also very vast. So you need to guys to have a lots of practice. There is many more tags. Please practice so that you can easily do your HTML designing when you are going to do the project. It will help you. Okay. Okay. So drag and drop is very common feature. What is drag and drop? Drag and drop is nothing. When you drag something and set at other place, it's called drag and drop. You will drop there and it will automatically set. Like now, if I show you one example, let me show. If I drag this and drop there, it will set there, right? If I draw there, it will set there. Are you able to see, guys? What I am doing, I'm just dragging the table, empty table, and setting at the different place. This is actually called drag and drop. We need to remove this table. So drag and drop is very common feature. As you know, we have to grab the object and drag it at, drop at the different location. So how we have to make the element draggable. So how we can make a drag element, your element draggable? We have to use this property. To make an element draggable, we have to make this attribute true. Only then your attribute will be draggable. So what to drag? This is the thing. But here also, guys, we need to have some JavaScript part. or might be calling a function. So it will be, maybe you will not able to understand, but I'll explain this in this thing, in this session only. So right now, okay, first of all, I think so I'll show you the example. It will be very good. Then we'll go to the theory part. Guys, this is the image. It's right now, it's out of our rectangle, and rectangle is empty, right? I'll pick this image and drop there. It's going to set there. How this thing is happening? This is the whole coding behind, just to drag the small image to a defined rectangle. CAPTCHA, I think so. Sorry, I'm not. Kunal, can you elaborate your question? If I refresh, it's going outside, but if I drag and drop there, it's going. So how this thing is working? To drag, here is the function. Drop, here is the function. To allow that drop, we are actually using this function. So all this part we will do in a JavaScript. Okay. Div is nothing. Div is, I'm going to be giving the ID. Div is nothing. We are just having that division of our screen. I'm dividing in a smaller div, the rectangle we are making. So here I'm calling the functions on drop, on drag over, drop event. I'm passing that event. Here I'm allowing the drop. Here I'm included. Here I'm going. Yeah, this is the JavaScript part. I know from that only you can actually do that thing. So Kunal, I'm waiting for your question, buddy. Can you elaborate? I know. But guys, if you, okay, I'm understanding you are not, we have not done the JavaScript part, so you're not able to understand, but how functions are calling, how you are, actually these things are working, right? I'm understanding your point of view. I'm just want to you to understand. Are you able to understand the HTML part? Skip the JavaScript part only. Here is the JavaScript, HTML part, image tag, ID I already explained you, src. Here is the URL. I'm draggable true, right? On drag start, you're not able to understand right now, right? But are you able to? Okay. So someone I can ask, what is on drop? Is an attribute? No, buddy. On drop is not an attribute. On drop is an event. It actually occurs when you make this true, na, draggable attribute true. So you can use this on drop, on drag over, on drag start. These are the events for that. And what are the events? I can explain you in JavaScript part. Sorry. I know. Okay, you are asking that when we are logging, we have to give the username and password, and after that they are asking some CAPTCHA, right? You are asking out that CAPTCHA, right? If I'm not wrong. Okay. So guys, Kunal's question is that how will we make that CAPTCHA? Okay. Okay, guys. For that, na, there is a whole process is there, Kunal. First of all, if you want to generate a random captcha every time, or if you want to have the database for that, you have stored some captcha, you will fetch from that, and after that you will show on your screen. It totally depends on your scenarios or on depends on your demand. Okay, so if you want to generate a random, then you need to use the random functions whatever available that is in the JavaScript also, or you also you can use the DB part. You can store in your DB, fetch from that and show at the UI part. UI is user interface. So use at the user interface, if you want to have, like you have seen the captcha is not a sim sometimes the simple text, right? Like in IRCTC sites, a simple text, or some websites are having very unique captcha and it's not clearly visible, right? So to make that not clearly visible, to make that not clearly visible, you can use the CSS properties, you can use the HTML part to make that so that you, when you fetch from the DB, you can make that not clearly simply visible. You can change according to your requirement. Yeah, Sahil has also given his input that they change their background. I'm explaining the same thing. I'm just giving you the more not images you can change. You can also change the font size. You can also change the background colors. You can also change the style of. You can also change the font family. Maybe you can also change the positions of your captcha. Right now, if you want to have at the top left right corner, if you want to have different colors of every character, you can do that. Right? From that, if the captcha is not clearly visible, but in their websites, the captchas are nothing. They are just doing the random generations, but they are also storing at the same end, their end. When you enter the captcha, they are just validating how, when you have entered the captcha, they are when they have stored, they are just comparing those captchas. Okay. So right now, are you guys able to understand drag and drop? Just practice once. I know you guys can easily understand because when you guys, okay, the only HTML part, when you guys able to understand now what are events, how their events are occurring, then this thing will be nothing for you. Okay. Okay, guys, can anybody might now you have to tell me, we are almost about to end our HTML part. Can you tell me what I have highlighted in my screen? What is actually about? Okay, style. That's clearly visible. Okay. Okay. Yes, some of your students are giving me right replies in my chat. Like, if you give the div one ID to another div also, na, then the same properties will be the same width, height, padding, border will be applied to the same another divs. Okay, guys. So moving ahead. Let's see what we are left in theory. We have covered attributes, we have covered basics, canvas, SVG editors. Okay, almost we have done in our HTML part, very basic things we have covered. Guys, have you made your pages? Are you able to make? Okay, so let me show you one thing. Okay, that is Okay, guys, give me a minute. I'll be back. You can ask me in a chat if you have any doubt. I'm going to reply that. Just ask me. No issues. From previous sessions only, before we start our CSS part, I just don't want you have any doubt in HTML. Directly we should move to another part. Should I ask questions? So no doubts. Really good, yeah. So if, how you will give the tooltip to any tag guys? Just reply me fast because we need to end this thing. Just reply me quickly. How you will guys give the tooltip to your any text? Any tag or any text also. How you will guys give the tool tip to any text? What attribute you will use in your tag? No guys, tool tip. Wrong. Anybody answer me quickly guys? You know that you have used. I have already shown you the one example. No canal. How you will guys give the tool tip to your text? Now my question is clear to everyone, or am I not audible? Which attribute I'm asking, Dilip? From which attribute you will guys get the tooltip? Yeah, Amit has given the right answer. You have to use the title within a tag. Only then you are able to give the tooltip. Have you guys really practiced? Please practice, guys. Okay, guys, there is another thing from my side. It's not in your syllabus. It's like a web storage. But I really want you to show. Someone yesterday has asked me about the local storage. So guys, there is some code behind that. So we can actually store a local, in your local, you can actually store that in your local storage. If it's not supported, it will be say undefined. But if your so from undefined, you will get the message. So your browser is not supported the web storage. But if your browser is supporting, I'm just getting the last name, but I have defined here. I'm just setting the last name as my last name, Gupta. But when I'm just getting that inner HTML, my inner HTML is nothing. It will just print whatever I'm going to set there. Okay. I'm getting the ID result. I'm just displaying my last name, and here is displaying my last name. So just locally storing the value, whatever you are going to do that. I have not made the document for this. I'll surely make it and just share with you. Are you able to see, guys? Why I have to ask you every time? I'm not getting response from your end, guys. It should be your end. I have to ask every time that, are you able to see? Are you able to listen? Are you able to see the difference? Your response must be prompt. So yesterday someone has asked me about this, right? So I'll explain in the later lecture. So here is the example, guys, how you store the local storage. Okay, local storage only. So whatever you have mentioning setting in the local storage, here is the key you want to in the key part, and here is the value. So how will you guys use this local storage? Why I am telling you this thing? Because sometimes if you don't want to connect your database and it's only at the locally part, at the local end you want to display something, and you want to pass another thing to another page, you can do through the local storage. Okay, this is the HTML local storage, the web storage for that. It's not storing at any database or anything. It's just for at the local storage. And one more good example. Right now, what actually you're saying, click the button to see the counter increase. Okay, I'm clicking on that. Here is the, not your PC is acting database, you are just using the local storage functionality of the HTML. So I'm clicking, as I'm clicking, it's increasing the counter here only. Okay, I'm refreshing it. That line has gone. But do you guys think if I'm click here, what will happen? I had clicked 5 times. Now what will be the text here? When I click, it will be considered from 1 because I have refreshed my page. Okay, let's check. It's 6. Okay, we'll click again. We have clicked 10 times now, okay? It's maintaining the actual, it is actually the session. It's maintaining the session. Until or unless you're closing the tab, it's maintaining the session. Okay, I'll again refresh my page. I'm refreshing so much time. Session, then, it's not saving, it's maintaining your session. I'll show you the source code after that you're able to understand. This right now, just see one thing. Maintaining the session. Okay, we'll close the tab I have closed. We need to run that again. Okay, now tell me what will be the count. If I click, yeah, it will be start from 1 because the session has expired. We have closed the tab. And it will be start from at the new end. When we click here, clicking unlimited time, just refreshing my page, the text has gone, but it's maintaining the session. How is doing? Let's see the source code. Here is the source code for that. Using completely the JavaScript function calling everything. And here is your HTML part. I'm just calling the event. On my click, just click my function click counter, and I am making this click counter here. Make sure the name is the same. Only then on click your function will be called. Otherwise, your function will not be called. Okay. If you give the wrong name, okay, let's see what happens. if I give the counter one name, just save there and refresh my page. Okay, now it's just not working. But guys, do you know how to inspect? How you are able to see what error is coming? Okay, control the site. It's not working for me today, right now. Okay, right now if I click from right click here, if I'm clicking here, nothing from where I can see my errors. Wait, guys, no. So someone has also asked me, can we get error in our HTML? I have clicked 19 times when he's trying to call the click counter one, but he's not able to refer that click counter one. Let's change our that part. Save it again. Okay, and refresh our page. It will start from refresh part clicking. Now it's, nothing is coming at console, right? Because there is no error, your application is working as you want. So explaining our code, we are using the storage, type of storage. Yeah, I already told you that there we are from today. Actually, there's whatever the topics, we have to be using some JavaScript part. And I already told you, I will explain this thing when we have covered JavaScript. At that time, in 15 minutes only, you will be able to understand what's actually going on. So, Sai, do you guys having any idea about JavaScript? Anyone? Might be some students are having experience on HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Anyways, having a little bit only. Yeah, works backend. It's a client side language or it's a server side language? Do you know the difference between client side or server side? Okay, we'll deal, do it later. Yeah. We'll do it later, but right now I don't want to discuss. So this is that some extra from my side. There is no nothing mentioned there. I have to show the sessions and anything. No side, it's a client side language. It's not server side. Okay, I'll explain you when we are at the JavaScript part. Okay. So guys, to maintain a session, we need to use the session storage. Okay. If we don't want to use any another thing another than HTML JavaScript, we need to use the session storage. Okay, guys. So from this, guys, we have covered your HTML syllabus. So I'm closing all the things. So should we start from CSS today only? Because we are ahead of us according to our guidelines. Hello, I'm not getting any response. Today also my voice is not clear, guys, because I've changed my laptop. I've changed my headphones. I've changed my network. Everything is changed today. Okay, because I have discussed with your team also. So if you guys agreed, we can have the morning sessions, but they told me it's between me and you guys, so we need to decide. So please guys, respond me in a WhatsApp group or anything you want, will do accordingly whatever you want. Okay. Because right now I have to rush my from office. Today also there's so much thunderstorm, but luckily I have left from my office on time, so I'm able to be here at 7:10. So I'm okay. I know one or two students are not fine. Yesterday we have one student, Abu Star, I think, so he is not fine. So guys, I have one suggestion. I'm not forcing you. You guys going to have the video sessions from the. If I start, I'll start from next Monday, from 17th only. If I start, so if you miss the sessions, you can have the videos. And for you, whoever will not join in our morning class but see the videos, I'll take that separate 15 to 30 minute session in the evening to just clear their doubts if they have. But they need to confirm me, they need to have the session in the evening. Only then I'll take, else I will not take. Okay? But we need to discuss that. So I'm giving you 2 days, just confirm me by Friday. If you want, your attendance will be considered if you see the, if you give me the task, because after seeing the video you will have to do the task. Or I am trying to do one thing, so giving you the task by email. So if we can do that, it will be great, because in future I'm going to give you some images, not images, it's called template. You have to make that templates using HTML CSS. Sahil, don't worry about your attendance. And Sahil, have you seen the link of attendance? Sahil, am I audible to you? So, Sahil, I think your name is not there. Can you please check, or you are not... I have just seen the link. I'm not able to see your name in the web development. All the students are there. Just please check with your Gurukul team why your name is not there. Okay. Okay, guys, let's move to the CSS part. Just intro today, from tomorrow only. Okay, guys, when you want to, when you guys want, I should give you the Git session. It will be in a half an hour session, but it will be at our end session, like when we are starting at 7. If we are ending at 8:30, I'll start Git session at 8. Okay? It will be in half an hour session. So I'm planning to give you at on Friday. Okay? So be prepared. And please download Git for Windows if you are having Windows laptop. I can show you here also. Go there, or you can directly go to there. So whatever machine you are having, just download according to your configuration. You are able to download. I am already having, so I'm right now testing. Okay, guys, please install this in your PC. Else, in that session, there is no use for you, because we will do parallelly. I can tell you the commands. You similarly, you will going to have that in your PC at the same time you are attending the session. Can we do that? Please, guys, can I have a response from everyone? And please make your account here, github.com. Sign up there with your email. Okay, because we need to use these things in our Git sessions. Okay, guys, I'll give you the URL in
WhatsApp also. Yeah, please Rojak, tell me. Is typing, so he's typing. So guys, please make your account here. It's nothing difficult, just you have to give the username, email and password. You can sign up. Okay, so further I'll tell you how you will do that. Right now just do two these things for the grid sessions on for Friday. I'm giving you enough time. Okay, when we are having this session, there's no issues. You will be able to understand how you push your code in a Git, your Python, whatever code will be there, whether it's a Java or whether it's any file you want to put at GitHub, you can do that. Yeah, no issues. Whether it's a Java, HTML, CSS, Python, you can do anything. You can push anything to your GitHub. GitHub is just nothing, it's a cloud for you. If you make your repository public, everyone can access it. If you make your repository private, or you give access to anyone, only that members can access it. No other members can access it. Okay? I'll explain you everything in a great session. I'm sure it will be a great session for you guys, because after that I will see your task there. Okay. Just one request from my side. Girls, can you please reply? I'm not getting replies from your end. I can see the replies from the guys. We are having girls too, right? If I can name it then. Pooja and Anjali. Guys, are you clear what till now? What we are doing and what we are planning? Dilipa asking from girls. Because I'm not getting replies from your end. Okay? You have not tell me this thing, Napuja. You have to tell me. Guys, my voice is not clear. Can anybody tell me my voice is lag? Whole session. Okay, guys, just give me a minute. Okay, right now we can check, because I have switched off my fan. Might be snow, is their voice. Just let me know if you face the same issue. Because I have switched off my fan also, now there's no noise in my room. Okay guys, now let's start with our CSS session. So CSS is nothing, is the stands for cascading style sheets. So right now guys, till now we have covered our HTML part. So HTML part is covering our attributes, elements, tags, everything. But are you guys happy with your HTML? So by seeing their appearance, it's very boring, I think so, right? There's nothing. To make your HTML pages more beautiful, we can say that, or we can most they make appearance more efficient. So actually, how your website if I can say that the multiple HTML pages, how actually we can design with the various layouts or something, we have to use the CSS. So from their name only, it's clear, it's cascading the style to your sheets, right? Cascading the style to your sheets. So it saves a lot of work because we can have the multiple web pages at the once. Okay, what does that mean? CSS saves lots of work. It can control the layout of multiple web pages all at once. What does that mean? It actually means like we can have our CSS as an external sheets, okay? And we have to just link our external sheet to our HTML pages. Whatever you have write in your CSS method, yeah, exactly. So actually CSS sheet will be applied to all the HTML pages in whatever you have linked, okay? In HTML pages, you have to link your CSS if you are using external style sheets. In my coming lectures, in my coming CSS examples, I am using inline CSS. I'm not using external style sheets because I want you two guys to use the external style sheets. You have to do nothing. Whatever I'm CSS applying in inline, you have to just make this copy and paste it another file in a CSS file and use that CSS file in your code. Okay. I'll show you one example, but after that, I really want you two guys to show me my examples using external CSS. Okay. So why we want to use CSS, I already explained you that we are including the design layout, the display variations. We want to, according to screen sizes, according to different devices. So actually CSS solved this problem. We have to format our page. So it actually solved a big problem. So how it's actually solved? Right now, you can see we have done this in our first example, in HTML first example. Might you guys have remembered in our first.html I have written for you guys, right? In that I was doing nothing. I was just doing this thing, right? So when tags like font, colors, we are added in, it's actually added in the 3.2 specifications. 3.2 is a HTML version, right? I told you this about the HTML versions. From 3.2 specification, they added the font and color, right? But it's very difficult. So solve this problem, W3 has created CSS. So CSS removed the style formatting from the HTML page. So removed, actually it's removed because they are providing you the syntax from where you can actually put the CSS part and it will be applied to your HTML page. So where we have to write our CSS? So you can use the .css file, okay? Or you can write in a style tag. In the last example you have seen, I have used a little bit of CSS part. I'm giving the CSS to a particular ID, right? So by just changing implementing the CSS, your whole website look will be changed. So let's go for first example. Which example should I show you? I'm thinking. Okay, let's go with background only. Okay, guys. I'm doing nothing. Okay. This is the same you have seen in your HTML page, right? This is the same. There is no difference. this part is also the same from head, right? What is the change? Change is here in a style tag. In a style tag, I'm giving style, background color to the whole body, right? Are you able why I'm writing body here? It will be applied to the whole body. I'm giving the background color as light blue. I should open the code in a notepad. Okay, if we give the red, and we just save it here and refresh our page, it converts to red. It will be automatically applying to the whole body. It's not applying to a particular tag. Okay. Are you able to guys catch up this thing? This is a very basic part of CSS. We are doing nothing. We are just giving the normal background. Okay, you want me to apply this for a particular P tag, right? Okay, let's see what's the example, how it will show. Clear, Vivek? How you can do it? We are doing nothing. Okay, guys. This is the good thing we have done. We'll do thing. Okay. This make more clear. If you do this thing for a P, in whole page, whenever you apply a paragraph tag, it will automatically apply background color to that. Guys, I'm not sure you are getting this or not. Please reply. Okay. I hope I have given the answer, Amit. You have asked me this thing, right? So if you want the same CSS properties to apply to multiple tags, you can do this by this thing. Actually, this is our CSS topics. We'll cover all these things. This is just an intro to you. Okay. So I'm giving the live. Why I'm giving the live example? So you can also do the same thing, guys. I really want you to do the same things. Okay, guys. Just one more thing. You can inspect these elements also. You have applied this thing in body. If you select this thing, it will show you. By default, what is the margin, what is everything, and background color is light blue, right? Are you able to see, guys, what I'm doing right now? If you don't want to change your code again and again, you want to save that, and again, you want to go for a different, refresh your page, I'm saving your time. By this, you can save your time. It will save your time or not? Because you don't have to go to your code again and again. You can give color like this also, whatever what color you have liked. just click by this only. It will automatically generate a hex code for you, and it will automatically set. You can see, okay, you have liked this thing. Okay, one thing, if you have liked, you have to do just nothing, just copy from this and paste at your code. I have missed the last question. Can you, it will save .html. No, it's just temporary. You are just inspecting this thing. If you want to save, you have liked this color, and if you want to save this thing, because if I refresh now, just automatically convert to light blue, because in your code you have mentioned you want a light blue color. Just like this. You have liked this thing, right? So just copy this thing. Just copy this thing. Go to your code and paste there. Okay. Now just I have saved. So if I select a different color here, okay, but I refresh, it will come back to your previous color, but have you liked. Guys, this will, I am telling you right now this because you need to, while applying the CSS, sometimes you need to see the, change the values. Okay. So it will save your time. You can see immediately, you can see what is happening to your HTML page. If you want directly, if you want the same as it is, you want in your actual HTML page, just copy the properties from there and implement there. Okay. I hope this will help you. Okay, guys. So should we continue with next topic, or should we do tomorrow? HTML template, okay, only HTML, not applying the CSS, only HTML template. It will be in the format of image, but you guys need to design with your code. When we'll run your HTML page, sorry guys, when I'll run your HTML page, I should see something like that only. It is fine. So it will surely helpful for you. So okay, I'm saying I'll send you one image on WhatsApp that can be made by your HTML only, not CSS. It's like, it's called a template, but it will be an image for you. You need to design that image. It will be like a HTML page. You need to design that HTML page with your code, coding skills, or with your whatever we have studied till now. Whenever we run, like we run our HTML page now, we'll execute with this thing only. Like whenever I click on your page, it should display me whatever I want you to make. Am I clear? So it will help you guys, and it will help me also to understand what actually you guys are up to, right? Okay, we have the time, I think, so we should cover more things. Okay, let's start with this. We should start with this. Okay, guys, I hope the green highlighted part it's very clear to you. We already done in our example. When you are selecting a tag, it's called a selector actually. It's a rule in your CSS. You have to start the curly braces, then you have to give the property, then its value. If you want to use the multiple, you have to use the semicolon. Same property and value. Very clear? No issues, I think so, from CSS till now. So selector points to an HTML element you want to style, right? I already explained you, whatever element you want to style, you have to give. That is called selector. The declaration block contain one or more declarations separated by semicolons. Each declaration includes CSS property name and value that we already know. The CSS declaration always ends with a semicolon and that surrounded by curly braces that I already explained you. He is giving this example. Till now, we have covered. What say, right? So, let's see the code. It's using the selector, but now it's not a P. They just want to align center and color red for first paragraph only, not for the second. If you write the P there, it will do for the both of the paragraph tags, right? But if you want to have the different, you have to use this ID. And the same ID you will use there with a hash symbol. Let's study about this CSS selectors. I'm actually talking about the CSS selectors. Sorry. The CSS selectors are used to find the HTML based on their element name, ID, class, attributes, and more. Right? So this thing we have covered, then ID selector actually I'm talking about. So ID selector is nothing. You will give the ID to your particular paragraph tag or any tag you want to give the ID, you can give the ID. Just give the ID and use that ID with a hash symbol to implement your CSS properties. Yeah, ID is very much, must be unique if you want a single tag to be implemented. But one more thing, guys, if you want the ID, if you give the ID in a paragraph and a head tag the same, and for the same ID you have implemented sub CSS, it will automatically apply to the head tag and the paragraph tag also. Okay. So ID is nothing. ID is a unique attribute if you want to apply within a page, right? Hash symbol. Why hash symbol? If you ask me why hash symbol, is just the standard to understand you are using the ID. And for this ID, they need to implement the CSS, right? In the I have closed that. I need to reopen that. Right? Para hash symbol. Para one is your ID. It is already, we have seen that it's already implemented for the paragraph one only. The second paragraph as it is, we are seeing in our HTML. Okay? Let's do one thing. Give the same ID to the second paragraph also. And run it. Or refresh it. Okay, guys, we have just applied the ID to a paragraph. We have applied CSS to the given ID, but it will automatically apply to both of the paragraphs because ID is the same. If I change the ID, and do one thing, I hope you know what will be the output, right? Right, guys? by this only I know it's very easier. Now it's making more sense. Like now this thing, you need to move your external CSS file and you have to just link here. How we can link, I'll tell you tomorrow. But right now, just understand this thing. But the highlighted text, you have to save the .css file externally and you have to link there here. Okay. Moving ahead. The class selector. Class selector is nothing. When you give the name class equals to a name, then you have to use the dot symbol. By dot, it will understand the name of the is a class that needs to apply the CSS. And how you will give the class? Okay, let's see with the code. Okay guys, it's very similar to your ID. You just need to use the dot symbol, your class name. Here you are giving the ID, you need to give the class. Then you have to use the, just give the value and same value you have to use here. From dot, the CSS HTML will understand there should be a class where the CSS needs to be applied. Okay. So let's run it. Okay, guys. For both headings and paragraph, the CSS has been applied with the class name center. Okay, any other one? The same question. Anyone want to tell me, sorry, if you want to tell me the difference between class and ID? Anybody knows? Okay, any other thing? Yeah, Rochak has given the right answer. Actually, ID is to identify the unique element, but class can be used to identify more than one. Nothing is like that. The faster you are, it will be in the milliseconds only, you will not be able to understand. But if you really want, you can check it. But I don't, according to my experience, there is nothing so much difference in that. There is, whenever you're searching for that, na, classes are not actually unique. IDs are always really unique. Okay. The second difference is all just a difference. There's nothing, the, according to CSS, the implementation, we have to use the hash with the ID and dot with the class. Actually, na ID you must use. We have done the example that I have given the ID to the two paragraphs. But actually, ID is not used like that. ID can be given to a particular one tag so that it can easily be identified that this ID is using in this tag only for particular tag, right? But class can have multiple, more than once we can identify the attributes. So class you can use in multiple tags also. Okay. Guys, grouping selectors, can anybody tell what will be the grouping selectors? We have already covered. Exactly. We need to give separated by comma. You can apply the same CSS to multiple elements or tags. This is called group selectors. Then there is coming CSS comments. What is CSS comments? Guys, you know what actually comments are. Actually, comments are nothing. You can give description when you are actually doing the large code. You can, if you want to understand which, if your code is not done by you only, is having a multiple developers or multiple things, and you're using or working on a, yeah, it's actually for reference only, it doesn't execute. Absolutely right. But actually, why we are using, when we are having a multiple team and you're using on a same project, you are having the same, working on a same thing. So if you want to tell the your another developer or another persons what you are actually doing, you must give the comments there so that they are able to understand this thing, that this actually your method, your HTML page, your tag is actually doing this thing. It will be really, really helpful for others also, and you also when you refer in the future. So it's just for the reference only. Okay. So how we can actually give the comments? For a single line, you have to use this format. Slash star your comment star slash. Okay, for multiple line comments, you have to just give the multiple lines comments and end it where you want to end it. Okay, guys, I think so. This is enough for today. I surely give you homework, not homework, sorry, mistakenly. Say that I'll give you the task. Okay, so it will be on your WhatsApp by next 1 hour or 1 or 2 hours. I'll post it. Please try to make that HTML pages, and if you want to apply CSS, just please, you are free to apply. Okay, I'll mail these things to your Gurukul team, and surely they are gonna share with you. Okay. Okay, guys, from my yesterday's session, I have asked you one thing. Dilip has initiated some talk about that also. What will happen if you don't close your tag? Just give me quickly response. We need to end this class in 5 minutes. Just quickly give me the response. What will happen? Dilip have already explained their part. Any another guy want to just give me the explanation, or should I give you? Are you able to understand that part or not? Just give me that answer. Okay, that's honest answer. If you're not able to understand, just let me know. Guys, are you there? Okay. I have made some code for you guys. Okay. Okay, guys. This is something I have made for you guys only, to just to explain you what actually matters or not. Should I run this, or are you able to understand this? In one example, in one unordered list, I have not closed the tags. In another, I have closed properly, right? On that li, I have just written, this is a CSS prop. No issues, Dilip, we will get this part, no issues. You can see the video when you will get the link. Okay. So li empty is nothing. This is the CSS, you will cover that. I'm saying whenever the li empty, li having no elements, don't display me. Okay. Don't display me that part. Should I run this? Are you able to see the difference? I have clearly mentioned in my code, if li is empty, don't display me. Display none. When I'm closing the tag properly, it's working my code, but when I'm not, it's not able to understand where is close is tagging, where is tag is closing. So he actually HTML in my HTML page while running is showing me all the dots false also. They are not able to understand where list is first element is ending, where second element is ending, where third element is ending. It's just showing me that. But in my next example, I have done that. Guys, explain you again? What are the benefits from this example? You are able to understand what are the benefits, because sometimes if you don't close your tags, the HTML can render anything not according to your requirement, then it will not look nice. It will render at any point because it will not able to understand where it's ending. So it can be do anything. When you are saying that it's working fine, we're not able to understand because you are using different tags, right? So yeah, if it's working fine, you are using different tags, then HTML can understand, okay, this tag you are using the next tag. So it's showing the correct output. When you're using the same tag, now it will surely ambiguous and it will be a problem for you. Your HTML page will not render properly according to your requirement, okay? So please make habit, like you have seen me coding a part, little bit part in HTML, right? You have seen whenever I'm starting any tag now, before doing any content written into it, I'm closing that tag. Please make your habit according to that. It will, according to this, you will never miss to close that tag. Okay, guys. This is from my side today. Thank you very much. Good night. Okay. Yeah. Okay, guys, some tags are also a self-close tag. So you need to, you can study about this on a Google also, because there are many tags who are self-close, like BR. You're not, you have seen I'm using BR, but I'm not using that self closing that part. So you are just little bit studied about the self closing tags also. It will do nothing, buddy, if you do that. It's actually not required, but if you do that, it will do nothing. Okay, guys, that's from my side. Thank you very much. We'll meet you tomorrow. And one thing, guys, one last thing, and so sorry, I'm saying two times why I'm asking you again and again. Now I think so, voice is clear. So should I use this laptop and environment? Okay, that's good. Okay, please give this feedback to your team also if they have asked, because I've changed so many things for you guys only. So please, give this feedback. Okay. Thank you, guys. Bye bye. Good night.